Hello everyone. Today, I'll show you how to use motion path to move an object along a specified shape. As you may know, together with entrance, exit, and emphasis effect, ActivePresenter allows adding the motion path effect to objects, making them move along a predetermined path. This video will cover add motion paths, edit motion paths, and delete motion paths. Before learning this feature, you may want to take a look at the video Animating Objects to better understand the object animation. Now, I'll add and edit its motion path to this boat, making it flow to the treasure chamber along a predefined path. First, select the object. If you want to add the motion path to multiple objects at once, hold Ctrl while clicking to select multiple of them. Then, open the Animations tab and select one motion path from the gallery. You can let the object move along a line, a circle, or a star shape. Or, you can draw a custom path. I'll select custom path and draw a path on the canvas with the mouse. Click anywhere on the canvas to set the start point, and move the mouse to draw the line. Press the mouse and release it to create another point, and continue moving the mouse to draw the line. When you finish drawing, double-click to set the end point. After that, you will see the motion path effect appear as a dotted line, with a green and a red arrow on the canvas. The green arrow indicates the path's start, while the red one indicates its end. Let's preview the motion path. You are free to edit its size, shape, or direction easily. Select the path of the object, then, drag the entire path to change its position, or, drag the green handles to change its size. To edit path shape, right-click the path and click Edit Point. Or, you can click Effect Options and select Edit Points. Then, drag any of the black handles to move the portion of the path. To make the object move in the reverse direction, right-click it and select Reverse Path Direction. In addition, a motion path can be classified as a closed or open path. With an open path, you can close it. Right-click it, and click Close Path. This makes the object return to its start point when the path ends. As you can see, a linear path is added from the previous endpoint to the start point. When you move the object, the path follows it. If you don't want this to happen, that means you want the path to stay still when the object position is changed. You can lock the path. For that to happen, in the Effect Options menu, click Locked. Now comes deleting motion paths. To delete a motion path effect, just select it on the canvas and press the Delete key on your keyboard. Alternatively, you can drag its object time bar in the timeline pane downward. Keep dragging until it turns gray, and release the mouse button. That's enough for using the motion path to animate objects. Thank you for watching.